Welcome. In this session, we are going to understand how to develop mining tool project using PHP programming language. In order to understand this, we are using Eclipse IDE, and the Eclipse which I am taking is Eclipse for PHP developers. The version is Mars 1. The release is 4.5.1. You can make use of any other Eclipse for PHP development in order to write, deploy or modify this project. Now we have created a project mining tool within our PHP Eclipse, and here the first program which will execute is our index.php file. You can double click on this file in order to view the code inside. Now here PHP has a PHP Hyper preprocessor, and this preprocessor defines that the next lines of code are meant to be parsed with respect to PHP interpreter. So this is the PHP processor and this is the PHP end processor. All the lines of code between this processor will be treated as PHP lines of code. The very first statement which we are executing is session underscore start. Using this, we are starting a PHP session for a user. So here now let's write that start a PHP session for a user. So as soon as the user connects to this index.php file, some session variables will be stored into his browser and values will be identified using this session underscore start function. This session underscore start is used to start or resume the session. So we can use the session underscore start to start or resume a session. Once we are done with this, now what next we are going to do? We are going to understand that once we have resumed or started a session, now we are going to check if a session variable with the name name is set on the browser or not. So now in order to check that, what we are doing is using if conditions, we are executing another function which is known as isSet, and we are checking that within the session variable, if we have a variable with a name name. So if that variable is available, then we are going to call another function, and this function will be header function. And using this header function, we are going to define a location, and using this location, we are going to redirect to a file known as hadoop.php file. Now these lines of code specifies that once we have started or resumed a session, we are going to check if session variable name is available. So if it is available, we are going to redirect user to hadoop.php file using this header function. In case if the session variable is not set, then we are going to execute the HTML code, and using this HTML, we are using a language English, and the XML namespace which we are using is available on this URL, World Wide Web, w3.org, 1999xhtml. So all the tags which we are going to use in HTML language, the tags are predefined on this URL here. Now we have used a head tag, and within this head tag, we are using a meta tag in order to specify that we are using the character set UTF-8. Then we have described the title, and the title is login page. Then we are using a link for a style sheet, and we have referenced that we are going to use a style sheet, and the style sheet is available within CSS directory, and name of the file is style.css. So you can go to the CSS directory, and you can see that within this CSS directory we have a style.css file, and here we have specified the CSS codes in order to give a beautified view to our application mining tool. So in case if you want to make any changes to the design, you can come to the CSS file and you can modify that. Coming back to the code for index.php, next we have used a jQuery library and this jQuery library has been taken from jQuery.min.js. It's a JavaScript file, and using this JavaScript file, we are going to execute functions on the client side. These functions will involve retrieving information from the client's browser and sending it to the server. Now what next we want to do, once the head is closed, now the body tag has been written, and within this body tag we have created a form. In this form we have a division tag, and within this division tag we have specified the division tag with a class login card. This class login card is defined under style.css. So we have a heading tag, and using this header one we are specifying a title for this page, or we are specifying a heading for this page, and this heading is my name to login. Now we have created a paragraph, and within that paragraph we have specified enter username. Within that enter username we have used an input control. Within this input control we have specified id is equal to text1, and the type of this input will be text type. So this is an input field which will take text input, and that text input will be considered as a username. Then we have another label, that is enter password, and we have created another input control. The unique ID for this password is password1, and we are going to take the input content which will be password type. So that means stars will be represented whenever you will type in a password. Now what next we have? We have an input control, and this input control is a button control, and this type of this input control is button type, and the class which we are using is login submit. Value written within this button will be login. We have used an extra space, NBSP stands for space. And now what next we have is, then we have another input button 2, and this button 2 will be used to perform the registration process. So we have a button to login, another we have a button for register. So once we are done with this, the division tag is over and the body has been completed. Now we have written another script in jQuery, and using this we have used a dollar. This dollar is an identifier of a document, so we can control any document or a control using this dollar sign. We have to specify the unique identifier of the document or a control. So controls can be uniquely identified by their IDs using the hash symbol. So we have selected the document, and we have checked if the document is ready. That means all the UI controls have been loaded on the web browser. Then we are going to execute a function. So this ready starts from here and it ends at the bottom here. So now you can see that it ends here. Now what we have is, within this we have specified a function. This function does not have a variable or an input. So this function starts here and ends here. So within this function, now once a document is ready, we are identifying a button control using its ID. Hence we have appended hash symbol before the ID of the button control. ID of the button control is button 1. Now we have set a function on this button control, and this function is a click function. If somebody clicks on this button, then a function will execute. And what the function will do, this function will get the username using dot value function on the control text1. So we have identified a text1 control using its ID by appending hash symbol. Then we have fetched its value, and whatever value has been received, we have stored that value inside uname, and data type of this variable will be var. In the same way, we have identified password text box, we have fetched its value, we have saved the value to pname, and data type for this pname is var. Then what we did, we have executed a post function on the document, and using this post function we are going to send a post request to a file login.php. This login.php is available on the server. This login.php will receive composed properties, and these post properties will contain a key user and a key pass. Within this key user, we are going to append a variable uname, and this uname is the variable which we have fetched from the text1 control, and then we have appended pname with this post parameters. So user and pass, these two post parameters will be sent to login.php, and once we have received the response of this request, then within the response we'll check. If the response we have received is true, then we are going to replace the location variable on the window to hadoop.php. This means we will redirect the user browser to hadoop.php file. In case if login is not true, then we are going to display an alert message using alert function, and within this alert function we have specified a message that login failed, you have to try again. Once we are done, now in case if we click on button 2 control, so we have identified button 2 using hash and its ID button 2. We have set a click event on it. So if somebody clicks on button 2, a function will execute. What this function will do, this function will replace the location variable to register.php, and page will be redirected to register.php if button 2 has been clicked by the user.